Welcome back to Marriage Moments. This is Pastor Anthony Dagner, my lovely wife, co-pastor Shelley Dagner. We really hope and pray that you have been enjoying the segments thus far, that it's really proving to be fruitful and being a blessing to married couples, and then also too, to those that are looking to get married as well. Today, co-pastor and I, we want to deal with finances. We know that when it comes to finances, or we'll just say the money,
right,
that sometimes in dealing with money, that it can cause hiccups if you really don't know how to function and how to be able to flow together when it comes to your finances. And so, co-pastor, I'll kind of let you lead the way in this, and then we'll kind of go back and forth, praise God.
Okay. For pastor and I, first and foremost, we understand and we've been taught, you know, my bishop and co-pastor, everything that comes into our household belongs to God. And he's just allowed us to be stewards over it.
That's good.
After that, we understand that everything that we have is ours.
That's
good. It's not his or mine.
That's good.
It is ours. God uses different resources to bring the money into the household, but it doesn't matter about those resources. We understand that God is the source, and the source is providing for the household.
That's
and
good.
So there's no his money, my money. Can I borrow money from you? You know, because that sounds crazy. I'm borrowing money from myself. It's not a you're paying this or it, you know, I'm paying this. It's God brings it in and we take care. We're going after debt, supernatural debt cancellation.
Yes.
We're believing as a whole. A couple of things that I wanted to talk about from a woman, from a wife standpoint.
Okay.
Women need stability. It's major. So sometimes your wife, you know, maybe feeling a certain way or you're wondering like what's going on. Stability is important to us. We want to feel secure. So that's very, very important. The other part, and we'll come back to that stability piece, unless there's something you want to say Now, the other thing for women, this is an example of something that I would do. You know, when we were broke or close to it, you know, I was just in my la-la land. I didn't want to see the account. I didn't want to see the book. I didn't want to know what was going on because, you know, I wanted to, you know, spend or not even have the weight of that. And there's a portion of it that, you know, women don't carry or and shouldn't have the man of that role, you know, the role of the man and the provider and making sure things are in order. But I was just, you know, like in my la-la land, you know, I can spend, I can do whatever. And then every now and again, I'd go like, okay, where are we at? And he would tell me, I'm like, oh my God, how did we get here? And it's like, ladies, one, let's recognize what's going on there. And, you know, I knew like, okay, I'm spending, I'm doing whatever. I'm not that I wasn't checking in with him, but you know, he knew what I was spending on. But I wasn't looking at how was that affecting our plan.
Right.
How was that affecting our finances?
Right.
And then, you know, then we want to be shocked, you know, of the impact of our actions. So that's something, of course, you know, I don't do now. God has blessed us tremendously.
Yes.
But
praise God.
That was a lesson that I had to learn and give him the allowance to be like, you know, tell me no. You know, and we also got to that place again where he was like, hey, I'm not doing anything based on emotions that's going to impact my family and our finances. And we really, I think that was a moment when we really, God was able to do what he wanted to do in our finances and really bless us the way he wanted to.
Yeah, that's good. And you've actually said a tremendous amount in a short period of time, you know, in dealing with, again, that God is the source and then understanding what he funnels in. That we're really stewards over that. And I heard you say about security and stability.
Right.
And really when it comes to finances, you know, I'll just say it from this perspective that, you know, I may have been raised a certain way when it came to resources and finances. Co-pastor may have been raised a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
But what you have to do is you have to, especially if it's good things, let's put it that way, if it's good wisdom, good insight
right.
that you're bringing to the table, but then you also understand there may be some things that you need to kind of flesh out
right.
That can be a hindrance to the household. And so you really want to be able to do things, co-pastor, God's way.
Right.
And so I think, as you stated, first and foremost, recognizing that God is the source.
Right.
And it's something that Bishop often says, too, that you have to understand that you need to partner with God. Over in Amos, I believe it talks about Amos 3:3, I believe, how can two walk together unless there be agreed? And so for husbands and wives, you know, understanding that there's a need for us to be able to sit down, right, to come together, right, and be in unity about what it is that we're doing.
Right.
Many years ago, I used to have what was called a bill book. And so at that particular time, I mean, it was crazy. I mean, this has been many years ago, of course, but that thing was so thick and so fat, with so much stuff at that particular time. But again, praise God. Thank God for debt elimination. But now Co-Pastor and I have what we call a playbook. And so what we do is we sit down, we forecast. And when we're talking about forecasting, we're not just talking about from one paycheck to the next paycheck.
Right.
But you're looking months down the road of, okay, one, what are we going after now? Like,
right,
what is our target now? What are we believing God to do right now in this season or in what's to come?
Right.
And then we start to make a plan from that.
Right.
What is the saying that it talks about? If you fail to plan, you plan to fail.
Yes.
And so it's us coming together, recognizing too the strengths that the other one has.
Right.
Co-pastor is awesome in financial wisdom as well. Detail, mm-hmm, being able to forecast and project and things of that nature. And so it would be foolish on my part to not recognize that and understand that's an asset to our household. And so even for men, yes, I understand head of household, I understand being in the right roles, but you still have to make sure that you're recognizing the gift or gifts that God has placed in your helpmeet to be able to help you in this arena of finances as well.
Mm-hmm. And that's good. If your wife, again, is good with accounting and forecasting and budgeting, great.
Right.
But while Pastor allows me to flow in that, and now he's kind of taking it back over, and I don't deal with it much at all other than just being aware of, okay, this is what we're going after now and so forth.
Right.
But it doesn't give you the exit, or I don't know the right word, but like, okay, you got it.
Checked out.
Yeah, checked out. That's perfect. That doesn't mean, men, you check out, because we still need you there, because that's security. It's like, I may be the one that's, you know, doing this or putting it in the spreadsheet or so forth, but men and husbands, you're still there leading and guiding and helping making those decisions.
That's good.
So again, that your wife doesn't feel the weight of
that's
that
good
role that really, you know, is the man's place in regards to leading and guiding in that arena. So work together. And again, you know, Pastor and I, and he was like, hey, this is what you're good at, but he wanted to learn, and then he took it over, and now I'm kind of like, he's leading and showing and saying, okay, this is what we're doing, you know, we stay this far ahead and this is what we're going after. And now I'm alongside like, okay, I know what we're doing. I know we're speaking the same language.
That's good.
Very mindful. You know, we were going after paying off our vehicles. And Pastor was like, hey, co-pastor, this is what I'm saying. You know, I'm this is how I'm saying in my prayer time. This is what I'm telling God. And we saw that manifest. And so now he's like, all right, we're going after the house. This is what I'm saying. And this is the timeline I'm saying, so that we can be in agreement. So he's leading that way, but I'm staying engaged.
That's good.
So I'm aware of, okay, what do we believe in God for to bring in and to cancel supernaturally?
That's good. Also, too, when you're dealing with finances, making sure that you're doing it, again, God's way, functioning God's principles. Even if I, you know, sitting here thinking about how with tithes, your offering,
yes,
understanding the importance and significance of being a seed sower,
yes,
in giving. And so those are things that you have to be mindful of, because what happens is when you're functioning in tithing, when you're functioning giving your offering, when you're functioning as a seed sower, being a true cheerful giver,
yes,
it now allows God to be able to invade in your finances, where he's able to do some things from a supernatural standpoint,
yes,
where it's not just the job or just the business, but God is able to now bring in supernatural resources,
right,
which in turn now allows supernatural debt cancellation to come into place as well. And Co-Pastor and I have personally seen that. We've been, as Co-Pastor said earlier, we understand, you know, being broke. We were in a place of being broke. We were understanding where we weren't necessarily always operating in financial wisdom.
Right.
You know, we've seen the experience of being putting, per se, all your eggs in one basket.
Right.
And so those were lessons that we learned from that. And so now God, you know, looking on the other side of, okay, God, what do you want us to do? Again, you know, we're being stewards of what it is that you're entrusting into us. And so how do we do this? How do we release this? Where do we sow? What are the things that we need to do that gives you access to be able to move in our finances?
Yeah, and I love that. I mean, think about it. The word says in 2 Corinthians, God is unwilling to abandon a cheerful giver.
Yeah.
And you reap what you sow according to what you sow. I mean, you can write your ticket here. You know, Bishop has talked about the excitement of tithes. I mean, we talk about in Malachi, it talks about, like, you know, that he will open up the windows and he will rebuke the devourer. I mean, that's a twofold blessing. Not just open the window and pour out the blessing.
That's good.
But he said he will rebuke the devourer on our behalf.
Yeah.
And all we have to do is give him 10% of what he's given us. And then he's going to multiply what he lets us keep. And he's still letting us keep the 90. It is just the word works. And
that's
when we talk about seed, unwilling to abandon a cheerful giver.
Yeah.
I mean, it's amazing to see what God does on the other side of that. God said, maybe, I forgot how many years ago it was, God told me, sow, flow, and go. That's all I heard. Now you think, sow, flow, and go. He didn't say go first. He didn't say flow first. He said, sow, flow, and go.
That's good.
And I shared it with Pastor, and I mean, we just start sowing on another level, and it's then you're able to continue to flow. You're able to go. I mean, we have just seen just tremendous leaps and bounds in our finances.
That's
and just an ease.
That's good.
And it's easy to sow. And as Apostle said, it's easy to have plenty of money.
That's good.
And you're beginning to walk in that, but you got to start in those principles with the tithes and offerings. Husband, wives, get an agreement.
That's good.
You know, it's what the word says. Try God. I mean, he is
proven.
Faithful.
That's what he
yes.
said. Proven.
Yes. He is faithful to his word. And then when you go beyond your tithes, your offering, now you say you're going to be a seed sower. Watch out. He's unwilling to abandon a cheerful giver.
That's good.
Amazing.
And when you said, mention Apostle Leroy Thompson Sr., I remember too that understanding that he made the statement, and I may kind of be paraphrasing a little bit, but he talked about how, because understanding one, that everything that comes into our hands, it's not for us.
Right.
Understanding money with a mission.
Yeah.
And I like how you added the word, because for many, many, many years, we had it written down. I had it when I used to carry a wallet, and co-pastor had it in her billfold.
I still do, actually. Yeah.
Over in Romans 13:8, when it talks about, oh, no man, nothing but to love him. And so when you start really standing on the truths of God's word, you know, that's locked and loaded. Oh, no, man. That's what God says when he talks about being the lender and not the borrower,
yes.
The head and not the tail. This is what our Father, our source,
yes.
Is saying to us. And so we need to be able to trust God in our finances. It's not about working. I know we don't necessarily have time for this for time purposes, but it's not about working six and seven jobs.
Right.
But it's about when it's like, God, you're in control of my finances. Holy Spirit, I need you to guide me and direct me. Tell me what we need to sow. What are the things that we need to do?
Right.
And I promise you that God will show up and manifest in your finances.
Absolutely. and people, sometimes you can get caught up. God wants us to live a prosperous life. His word talks about it.
That's good.
It says the love of money is the root of all evil.
That's good.
Not money itself. I think Apostle says evil not to have it. Because, again, a lot of hiccups in marriages come because of finances and can't pay this and can't pay that. Go back and ask, okay, where am I missing an assignment? Where
That's
am
good.
I eating my seed?
That's good.
Where am I not going after debt? You know, when Pastor says, hey, we're doing something, God gets behind him. He backs whatever comes out of his mouth. And so even as men of God, understanding, you know, or even as a couple, not just putting this on the men, as a couple, as a married couple, when you begin to go after debt, God will get behind you.
Yes.
And the money will come. And I mean, we've seen it. We said, hey, you know, no more car payments. God began to move. I mean, just every step of the way.
Yeah.
You just start. You believe what God's word is, what God's word is and what it says.
Yes.
And the other side of it, you do your part and you are going to see the manifestation of God's promises concerning your prosperity, concerning your finances.
Yes.
And I mean, we are walking in it. I mean, you all know our testimony. We've went from homeless to living in our dream neighborhood. And it's because we literally just locked into the principles of God.
Right.
We understood what his word says. We did not allow the struggle to become real to us. That's we understood good. We're going through this because of decisions we made.
That's
financial
good.
Wisdom we didn't walk in.
That's
but
good.
We learned from those mistakes. And Pastor said, okay, we're not making that move because I'm not doing this. I'm not going to make this move and affect my family in this negative way because I remember, you know, I'm going to follow God and what God tells me to do. And then I began to listen to that. And okay, let me trust the God in you. Okay, we're not going to move this way. We're going to shift. And now we're walking in, and this is still just the beginning, of this manifestation that God, this promise that God has given to all of his children.
Hallelujah. And as Apostle Leroy Thompson Sr. said, you know, for those that are connected and understand that the money truly just keeps on coming.
Yes.
And so again, we're living witnesses of when it comes to finances, you know, and I know that the Lord has allowed a lot of nuggets and insight to come forth. But really, you know, you as husbands and wives sitting down with one another, really like, okay, we need God to be in this. God, we want to do it your way. And again, functioning in his principles, trusting his word and doing things his way. And we guarantee you. Yeah, I can say guarantee you. How can you say that, Pastor? Because we've done it. We're living proof of it.
Yes.
And don't get caught up on the mistakes that have been made.
That's good.
Because God already had the mistakes accounted for.
That's good.
And so now what you're going to do, so it doesn't matter where you are, what stage you are right now in your finances, God is able to move when we're again doing things his way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank you all again for joining us. Again, we're praying that these sessions really are blessing you. Co-Pastor and I look forward to seeing you next time. God bless you.